You have seen that the yield spreads of Spain have been narrowing over the last 2 months because of the decision taken by the ECB. We have a very positive assessment of the OMT program put forward by the ECB. And now what we are doing is to consider all the elements that are implicated, in this kind of decisions. We will do what is the best for the Spanish economy, and also what is the best for the future of the Eurozone. But what I can tell you is that the perception that the Spanish government has about the OMT program is very positive. We think that this is a step in the correct direction, not only because it implies the possibility of buying bonds in the secondary market, but much more because it puts very clear that the institutions of the Eurozone are fully engaged in dissipating, in driving away, all the doubts about the future of the euro. And that's vital for the Spanish economy. The problem for Spain is not as much the situation of the yield spreads, but the volatility and the uncertainty about the future of the Eurozone. And these kind of actions, what make, is to put very clear that the ECB, a very important, extremely important Eurozone institution, the most important Eurozone institution, is fully engaged in dissipating this tail risk that was having a very negative impact on Spain and on other economies.
You've said before that you pay more attention to bond yields and borrowing costs than rating agencies. How high would yields have to go before it becomes unsustainable and you think you have to seek a bailout?
Well, I have to say that the Spanish Treasury has covered almost 95% of all the borrowing requirements of the Spanish Treasury. And so, our situation is quite comfortable in terms of financing the Treasury. We have liquidity. Even the cost of issuing our debt this year has been reduced in comparison with last year. And so, we are not under any sort of pressure in that regard. But we feel also that yield spreads in the area of 400, 420 basis points, as we have now in Spain, are putting pressure not only in the Spanish Treasury, but also in the Spanish private corporations that have to finance their investments and their expenditure decisions at much higher cost than other competitors. That's why we feel that, according to the calculations of the IMF, that the yield spreads of Spain should be much lower, because Spain is doing its part. Spain is putting forward an important program of fiscal consolidation, of a structural reform to foster growth, and is doing its part. And simultaneously, what we need is to dissipate, to dispel all the doubts about the future of the euro, because the uncertainty is about the possibility of the future of the euro is having an impact, a negative impact, and detrimental impact on the Spanish economy.